Ever wanted to know all about some of the most influential business leaders in the area? I'm going to peel back the layers and see just what makes them tick. So I'm talking with John Hennessy from Hennessy Coffee. John, you are a local businessman in the area. Tell me a little bit about your core business.
Well, our core business works mainly with the licensed premises of the area, clubs, hotels, and we'll do a range of quality coffee products for their cafe, restaurants, function areas. So you might see us in a club or a hotel near you, and we also have a range of equipment that goes well with our product range into that area.
Okay, so I'm trying to peel back the layers of different business owners and leaders in the area so people watching this can kind of get an understanding of what it's like to be either an entrepreneur or a business owner. But what's a typical day look like for John?
Well, mainly in the sales area, a typical day is getting up early, getting the team organised. I probably do about four or five venues a day. I love to look around at different venues and see what people are offering. But I'll go into cafes, clubs. We do a lot in retail. And right now, a big focus is our online services and really developing that online market.
Obviously, digital at the moment is massive.
It's massive.
How has your business changed over the years?
Well, I think we started off first, believe it or not, we started off with vending machines way back, a long time ago. And that sort of started into a little business for my wife and I, who's my business partner. Moved through to espresso, cafes, but it's been an interesting journey. And right through to club and hotel development, as they expanded and what they needed to do. We've just brought a whole range of different equipment and product to the market. So it's been an interesting journey, and I've met some fantastic people on the way who have guided us into products that they needed. And we've gone out and searched for those products via, you know, overseas trade shows or a whole range of different areas where we bring back what we think would work in a venue and sort of works for us. But it's been evolving. The coffee industry has been evolving, and you know, right through from coffee, our big product sales now are hot chocolate and tea. There's got to be something for everybody in the market. And coffee is very social, Trevor. Getting out and about for a coffee with family and friends is what it's all about. And for us to have a part of that by bringing a great quality product to a venue just allows us to be part of that connection. Very social product, and a lot of people get together. And as you can see around town, some fantastic venues starting to emerge for hospitality in both food and beverage.
Yeah, there's a lot of small bars, cafes opening up in Wollongong. It's really transitioning. So as far as your business, what made you kind of go, okay, we're on our own. This is going to work. What?
Look, a long time ago, we worked with a whole range of different businesses, and I think on my fourth or fifth business, we've always been entrepreneurial. We've worked for ourselves for a long time, met some great people in the Illawarra business community who have helped us along our way. I think the real transition was getting some traction in the market. I worked multiple jobs to get these businesses going. I've been a doorman, I've been a bricklayer, I've worked in juvenile justice as a project officer and sport and rec officer. All those little things we've done along the way have given us the skill set to get out and sell. The real traction occurred as one of our businesses really took off. I thought we could have a real go at this, and it was a family decision to have a go at that opportunity, and it's really paid off, but not without a whole lot of hard work. And I often joke with family and friends when they laugh and say, you know, you're going very well. I say it's taken over 23 years to be an overnight success. It's been hard, in particular in the sales format that I'm in, which is what I really like to do anyway, but working in sales is about meeting people, and I just really like to meet people and just bring some solutions to their business. So, you know, when they say that that old saying about, you know, if you do what you like and like what you do, you never work a day in your life, I really feel blessed to be able to sell to people, and I really enjoy what we do, and that's sort of how it's evolved. It's just slowly but surely over time we've grown into a quality brand. But I've really enjoyed the journey of getting along the way as well. I've learned a lot about myself and developed quite an extensive team that brings a whole range of skill sets to our business.
So tell me about the team. So how many people are in your business?
Well, we have six or so from the Illawarra, from Mount Warrigal through Winoona, Bulleye, heading up to our head office. We've got around about another five or six from southwest Sydney, Campbelltown, Camden, Holsworthy, and we've a whole range of contractors. And then we've also got our distributor arm, which is, you know, as far up as Tweed Heads through in Port Macquarie. We go down as far as Mallacoota. We've got distributors along the coast. And we work with cafes, and we work with a range of clubs and hotels. Aged care is becoming quite a market for us. So our team that we've come along with is in sales. We've got our technicians, our delivery drivers, our roasting team, and I'm in charge of product development, getting out and about and seeing what's out there internationally. So it's been emerging.
Okay, so hiring, firing, that's a big part of business. And how do you develop the skill set, and what sort of people
it's
do you
hard
look
one.
For?
Look, I love the hiring. Everybody loves the hiring. Look, we're a small team, even though we're around about, say, 13 or so in our team now, and plus subcontractors. We are a family-based team. My kids work in the business, Grace and Ethan. My wife's part of the business. I've spoken about this recently with some other people. Our team has become somewhat of our family. Business and in small business, lines are blurred between your co-workers. You often socialise, and we're often doing trade shows, so we get to know each other very, very well within parameters. And we certainly work well together. It's taken me some time to develop this team, but we have longevity in our team. So yeah, it's been good. The hiring, the firing part of it, well, it's all coming down to, as you know, with business, we very rarely have to, but most people self-select and will often opt out if they're not feeling part of the team or it's not working. But that's a difficult part of business, and anybody out there working in business would understand that the hiring's fantastic. But if things go wrong, you've just got to have some accountability, and you need to have those difficult conversations. But over time in business, you get used to having difficult conversations.
That's what makes the difference between a good leader. So what advice would you give a young 20-year-old John setting out in your career?
Look, people often ask, what would you say to somebody coming through the ranks? My take on it all would be, I often think back about when I was starting with that tenacity and not giving up and the day in, day out grind of trying to develop an idea. And I think where it comes down to me giving advice would be, if you have an idea, you've got to go for it. You're not going to possibly sustain some income from the idea straight away. That means you may have to have a range of other part-time jobs while you develop your idea, but you just got to keep going. Every day, you yourself in sales, you have to get up and go. And I love that. That really sustains me. I'm energized by that. I really dig the opportunity for me to prove to myself every day what I can achieve. So, but it's a hard one.
Having a crack, being persistent.
Persistent, yeah. and tenacity. And you know what? You can always say to yourself, I can do that tomorrow. Or look, I'll plan that. But look, you've got to have some structure, and you've got to get up and get organized. And it'll evolve anyway. Where you start to where you finish, you evolve along the way of business development and business leadership. You might think, I'd like to do that, but along the way, you're going to meet somebody that you think they're an interesting person, and they might give you a bit of advice, and you might alter your direction. Where you start is never where you finish.
Yeah, agreed. So take us to your product, Hennessy Coffee. What is different about your product to a lot of other brands that are out there?
Look, we've got, as I mentioned before, emerging out of what was vending coffee originally into espresso and all our other products. Our coffee, we have about 11 blends in our stable, and they're all available online or in a range of in venues. Look, our product range is solid. We've got, I think most coffee companies should have some quality green bean. If someone asks me what's the difference between my coffee and somebody else's coffee, I always come back to customer service. Everybody should have quality coffee now. We're all at that level. We're all buying quality green bean. It's coming down now to how it's supplied to you, from the delivery drivers to your accountability with your invoicing. Seamless. Make sure it's really easy for people to buy off you, because there's certainly someone knocking on the door as soon as you're leaving the building. It's really, really hard in the coffee game.
So taking it out of coffee even, when anyone who's thinking of starting their own business, whatever it may be, making it easy to purchase. And that's
make
what
it
I'm
easy.
Hearing. For. So whatever, if you're selling hats, you're selling donuts, or you're selling coffee, it's the same thing. If you make it easy to purchase.
Every time I go into a sale, it's all about honesty and integrity, of course, but how can I value add to the customer? I want to make the experience good. As I said before, I actually like dealing with that sales process. So if I can actually make it an easy sale, make it help the buyer out, it's all about seamless and easy, but also I want them to walk away knowing that they got a great deal and happy to do business with me again, because it's all about repeat business.
And talk to me about social media. So I have noticed your coffee cups getting around Australia lately.
That's outstanding.
There is a certain person we know that's moving along.
Yeah, Andrew and Peter Murray, who from Top Wire Traveller. Look, Andrew and Peter are travelling around Australia. They've got some. They've been to some fantastic locations, and they're family friends of ours. Our kids play soccer together. They've been family friends forever. And Andrew and I had a chat one day, and Peter and Christine were having a wine, and we thought, our traveling Hennessy Coffee Keep Cups, could they potentially go on a travel journey with you guys? And Andrew and Peter from Top Wire Traveller send back some outstanding photos of our Keep Cups in all sorts of locations around Australia. And for social media content, it's fantastic, but Look, it just keeps everybody happy and everybody upbeat at work when they see our product range visiting, you know, exotic locations from waterfalls to outback tracks. Certainly places I haven't been to yet. They live an exciting lifestyle, getting a chance and an opportunity to see Australia like I haven't been able to. And it's fantastic to watch your journey on their Facebook page.
Yeah, I was lucky enough to sell the house for them.
They're, oh, well done.
They're really good people. So as far as your business goes, what do you look for in an employee? So when you're hiring, is there a certain quality or strength?
Look, I think over time, Trevor, we've actually had to hire based on filling a void in our business that's emerged. So whether it be a technician or another salesperson or someone in admin. So from there, we've taken some great advice. We've used agencies before. Generally, you use some family, friends or contacts who say, you know, we might have someone that may fit or your team. Look, people say about word of mouth and opportunity knocks when someone might say, oh, I know of an opportunity. Often we'll find somebody within our own network. Mm-hmm. Our marketing manager, Ingrid Warburton, who lives in Winoona, old family friend of ours, has a lot of marketing experience and social experience. She's just joined our team last year and I've evolved as well. I've had to let go a lot of social and work with somebody else doing it. And it's been interesting to have someone else's insight into the business and bringing that quality skill set. But that was a word of mouth referral and it really works for us.
Tell me about social, because it's a very cost-effective way of marketing business, especially small business. But how has that evolved in your business and how has it grown?
Look, I think it allows for our sales team to have more of a reach with our product range. It also allows us to look at our business from another angle. So we're involved in photo shoots with our product range. Everybody's trying to bring content to the, you know, whatever we're doing. And we got a crazy team. They'll come from the weekend away saying, look at this. I've got this photo of this or that of our product in different locations. So it's exciting for us. It's another layer to our business and it's working. I mean, our social on Facebook, Insta, even our new online store, I get excited ticking over with our online sales. Yesterday we had 7 online sales. Tomorrow could be some more. It just works for us and it actually keeps our business, our staff excited and engaged.
What has been the best advice you've been given in your life as far as business goes?
Look, I have a retail background way back with the family at Kmart Bankstown. And when I was 14 to 9 months when we were allowed to start work and most of my family worked there and it was very, very interesting. And we worked with some great team members there. But I used to always hear about it. There's 3 things I can tell you about quality sales and all that sort of stuff is customer service, customer service, customer service. Really embrace the opportunity to engage with somebody and just do the right thing. And that's been ingrained in me from that far back. And I did a lot of time with Kmart back in the early days. I think I spent 4 or 5 years there in a part-time capacity while I was going through school and uni and different things like that. And those early days do teach you some lessons and you get a chance to work with some skilled retailers who really will start to let you know what they're all about. So that's for me a big, big tick. Customer service has been inbuilt in me for a long time.
What's a natural leadership trait that you have and what's learned?
For me, communication is a natural skill set because I want to, sometimes I over-explain things. Some of the things that I found along the way that I haven't liked doing or as we've grown the business, I've actually had to a chance to employ someone to fill that gap. Jesus, been good to offload some of the skills that I thought I could improve in that area, but now I've got someone. They always say surround yourself with a quality team. I think it's really, really important. But also from my point of view, I think you've got to focus on what you're good at. This hasn't been easy, starting with 2 people, my wife and I, and now working our way through. Even the last few weeks where I've been backpacking boxes and doing online deliveries, I've actually been getting online orders and delivering them to houses face-to-face and thanking people for a share for purchasing our product range. And that's been from all over Sydney. I've been doing that in the afternoons because business has been quite slow during this period. But when times are good and you're running hard, you're going to maintain the all of business approach. So
ups and downs are a common theme in most businesses. There's peaks and troughs. How do you level that out? How do you level your income out?
Different markets. So we've got our major market, which is the club and hotel licensed premises market, our online market. We're dabbling in retail. We're working with Harris Farm Market with a range of our products in 22 of their stores. And we've got other emerging markets, which they're emerging now, so I won't say too much about it, but we're spreading our risk.
So diversifying?
Diversification.
Yep, okay. So when you first started, so Hennessy Coffee, day one, Was there a business plan in place or was it a crack?
No, there was no crack. Mm-hmm. Look, but you could say there was, you know, it was the crack because we haven't a crack, but you also, the business plan that we started out with in writing is what we go back to, we were going back to every week at that time. Look, the plan was we'd already engaged in different businesses and we actually had a break in play for around about 6 to 8 months. Then we thought, well, what will we do next? And then we started working towards a plan. So a year or so after I sold one of my businesses, we were back in the game mainly because people were ringing me saying, oh, do you know about this? Or could you get me a machine? And I said to Christine, what shall we do next? And I pitched the idea at her. She said, we're gonna do it properly. And we put our name to the brand. So I've worked with a whole range of different coffee companies. Putting Hennessy on our brand, as in Hennessy Coffee, really put yourself out there. So we were going to do it seriously. And we actually got some assistance from our accountant. And we work towards a plan. Now that plan's evolved. I would encourage everybody that's having an idea to at least write it down and bounce it off some family and friends. I talked recently to a mate of mine from Balmain. He laughed. He does a lot of different stuff around the world. And he said, remember that time in the kitchen you were pitching that Hennessy coffee idea at me? And we had a laugh about it. And that was 13 years ago. And he goes, I can't believe what you did with that. And once again, we talked about before about the journey of getting along and checking things out and what we do to get each day. I look back and think that 13 years, it's not a blink in the eye to me. I know I could feel every day of what I've done. But like everybody else in business, it's the gravy is when you're out having a really nice dinner or you're out with family and friends and you go, oh, we're going to have a bit of dinner tonight or a nice bottle of wine or something like that. That's the gravy because you know the next few days after that you're doing your job again. You very rarely get the chance to pop your head up and have a breath. When you do, you do it with a little bit more enjoyment because you know you've worked hard for it.
Exactly. Have you achieved everything you set out for?
I have done a range of different jobs and I would like to see Hennessy Coffee expand into different areas, but we've just got to be careful here where we don't overreach. We're currently servicing the Illawarra, Southern Sydney. As I mentioned, we've got distributors and that sort of stuff. We are on the path of doing good things, but anything can happen. So you've got to be careful. And I don't want to overreach in regard to, I really like my lifestyle, Annie. The kids are getting a little bit older. I'm back in the water doing some different now, surfing and swimming and doing different things. Because sometimes in business, you may miss a few opportunities to do that sort of stuff. So things are starting to look good for us. I'd love to do some more projects, but you've really got to be careful about overreaching. And I think to myself now that I talked about some different ideas with some mates and we bounced some ideas off each other, but running one business like we're running now is pretty full time.
If you were to live anywhere in the Illawarra, where would it be?
I started life in the Illawarra in Coaldale, went to Bulleye, we've moved around a bit. I do like the northern suburbs because of the access to Sydney, but what every time I go to a new venue, what I like about the Illawarra is you can go to someone's house for a barbecue and you look up and you look at another view of the escarpment or you look at something new. Or the other day I came through Balgownie off Mount Ousley to do a home delivery. And I'm going down through the back of Mount Ousley, Balgownie, and I went, how big are the properties around here? Everything in the Illawarra, there's so much diversity. So, but I do like Bulleye. Hanging out at Bulleye is good. And I suppose from our family point of view, you won't get the kids or my wife out of Bulleye. They're loving it.
I think once you start there, you never leave. So I'm lucky enough to see a lot of the places you've mentioned. And there's some beautiful places in the Illawarra. And I think Sydney's already knows we're here. And a lot of locals would probably hate to hear that. But we've been found. So it's one of the best places to live. Yeah. What's next for you and Hennessy Coffee? What do you reckon?
Look, I think we're going to continue with the online. I think the social is good for us, working our online sales. That interests me. I'd like to see where you can take that. That is another thing that gets me up in the morning and a bit, it's intriguing how it all works. And I think the skill set you get as a business owner is you get a chance to dabble in everything, but I'm really interested in how that works and how far we could take that. Not for any other reason, but to see how far it could go.
Yeah.
That would be something I'd aim for.
Indeed. So any advice you'd give to someone starting out?
Look, once again, coming back to having an idea, bouncing your family and friends, working at what you want to do, and make sure you're prepared for some hard work. But how do you gauge success anyway? If your idea was to run something at a local market and you run a store and you got some experience out of that way, or you're targeting something international, have a dream and you just got to go for it. There will be a lot of people that tell you not to worry about it. There will be a lot of, you just got to remember that you got to focus on what you want because it's short. Doing business now for 23, 24 years, You could say, has it been quick? Well, it has been quick, but from where I sit, it takes every day is a journey, and you just got to keep going.
Perfect.
Hopefully that point was made there.
Yeah, very much so. So, John, thank you for peeling back the layers of Hennessy Coffee.
Thank you, Trevor.
And if someone wants to find out, what's your website?
HennessyCoffee.com.au. We're on Facebook, we're on Insta. Check us out. Please let us know, give us some feedback about our social. We're trying to be engaging, and any feedback is good feedback, Trevor.
Perfect.
And thank you for the opportunity to come in and have a chat.
No worries.